oh yeah, the economy's doing so well that now you can buy a house for the price of a car. Plus, there's more people on food stamps, and the Supreme Court says, if you get arrested, prepare to spread those cheeks.
Well, this is the Flint River.
Hey guys, it's April 3rd, 2012. My name is Reginald. I'm also known as Dimcad. Wall Street didn't react very well when the Fed said, hey, the economy's going so well, we don't need any more stimulus. Well, no, we don't need any more stimulus from the Federal Reserve because they're a big part of the reason why we're in this mess in the first place. But hey, since the economy is recovering, right, there's announcements that according to the survey of the National Association of Colleges and Employers, they found that in 2012, there's actually going to be a 10.2% increase in expected hiring. So they're expecting more companies like General Electric, who got away with not paying taxes 1 year, but anyway, Amazon, which, you know, I always shop on Amazon. It's pretty much the biggest online retailer. And Apple, they're going to be hiring people. So, I mean, is this a sign that the economy is getting better? Well, okay. 46.5 million people still on food stamps. Actually, it went down by about maybe 50,000 from December 2011 to January 2012. But it still stands at 46,449,000 people on food stamps. It had a little dips last year, but overall, the trend was up, up, up. And interesting enough, during that same period, they actually had an increase in the amount of people, well, the amount of households on food stamps. It went from 22,162,000 in January 2012, 22,188,000 people collecting food stamps. But hey, you know, things are getting better. In Spain, unemployment rises again. 39,000 more people in March ended up on in the unemployment lines, and they have a total for unemployment in that country in Spain, which isn't a small country at all, 4.75 million. Now, I don't know how they calculate their numbers because the way we do it over here is a bit shaky, you know, because for political reasons, we like to make things look better than they actually are. But hey, you know, things are getting better, right? The UK house prices drop the most in 2 years. Again, things are getting a lot better, okay? Lenders granted about 50,000 property loans in February. This is compared to 58,000 in January over there in the UK. But hey, you know, internationally, you can see there's obviously a decline. But back here in the U.S., factory rebounds, their orders actually rebounded 1.3% it was about 1.1% in the latest month, 1.3% in the latest month, but there's also a recent decline, so it's sort of a mixed bag right there. Pink slime. Okay, I told you guys about this. This is where they take meat, but they take the trimmings off the meat. Basically, a part of the part of the beef that they wouldn't serve the people normally, the trimmings, you know, this is part of the tissue that connects the actual muscle. This isn't like the stuff you normally eat, okay? They take this stuff and they grind it all up, right? And then they use ammonia to sort of take away the pathogens out of the blood, because it's sort of a mixture of blood and other parts. Anyway, McDonald's didn't want to serve it. A lot of restaurants didn't want to serve it. And, you know, now schools are starting to look at it. And there's actually one of the biggest makers. I think the maker is filing for bankruptcy. Well, I hope so. Because why would you serve this to human beings? I mean, a lot of times this stuff doesn't even have all the pathogens out of it, for crying out loud. I mean, is this really safe to serve the people? Obviously not. But at this point, they don't really give a damn. Okay, the housing market. Okay, now you can buy some homes around $10,000. You know that's true in places like Detroit, but also in places like Atlanta, Baltimore, Chicago? There's actually places where you can 165 homes listed at $10,000 or less. 207 in Baltimore. Absolutely incredible. Anyway, the Supreme Court ruled that, hey, jailers have the right to strip search you, even if you're arrested for minor things. So it was a 5-4 decision. They rejected this challenge by this guy in New Jersey who said he lost, bottom line. So now they can get you to spread your cheeks even if it's something really, really minor. So a cop could really punish somebody. You know, they could use like a minor infraction to sort of punish somebody for some personal reason. I'm not going to say all cops are going to do that, but you know, some psycho at a police department could decide to do that. Speaking of odd behavior, this is just flat-out foolishness, okay? Reverend Shabazz, this guy told people in Detroit that because Michigan is considered, the state of Michigan is considering taking over the actual area, the actual city, this has to do with the whole state emergency financer situation I told you guys about. Detroit looks like it's going to be a target for that because their finances are terrible. He basically said that the state of Michigan did this to us. He's blaming the state of Michigan. He's blaming failed school systems. They do have a school system that's failing. He blamed the banks. He blamed the suburbs for all the city's problems. Like, how can you blame all these other entities, you know, especially suburbs and all these other entities for Detroit's problems? I mean, at what point do we say, okay, we screwed up? Okay. A poll showed that only about 25% now support this war. Really, really low support for the war. And why would it be any higher? You know, it's becoming a complete disaster. Okay, and, you know, there's a whole issue of that massacre, which I don't know if it was just one guy, but they claim it was just one guy who's responsible for that. I'm going to let you decide on that. I'm going to let you dig into that. Anyway, we've been there for, what, over 10 years? What's the point? What is the objective? People are sick of it, and this is why I think Obama's trying to postpone the war in Iran, because he realizes that people are sick of it, and he wants to wait until after the election. At this point, I don't think it really matters between Obama and Mitt Romney. Their foreign policy is pretty much the same. They have the same irresponsible stance when it comes to the deficit. Very similar domestic issues. They both want to spend a whole lot of money. They both want the government to take over our lives. They just want the government to take over our lives in different matters, in different ways. Okay, China rejects Obama's Iran oil embargo. Basically, they're saying that you have no right to tell Iran that you can't sell oil here and here. And this isn't a surprise at all, because China has interest in that country, for crying out loud. A vaccine that may prevent heart attacks. This could be 5 years away, okay? 5 years away, scientists are saying that this is an actual possibility. Anyway, question of the day, is the economy getting better for you and those around you? If so, let me know, please comment, and give me a job. All right, don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today. Bye.